Here, drink this for the pain.
Oh, God, yes. And to think, I almost didn't bring the trap. I'd be dead now, if not for you.
Ain't supposed to be here.
Oh, don't mind me.
I said go.
Oh, you go. Again, girl. Easy there. Good girl.
do you think? Is it going to be a good
Mr.
day,
Morgan.
Mr. Strauss?
When did we last have
Mr.
a good
Morgan,
day?
Bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
I reckon I'm gonna think about it. Talk to Lenny.
Ah, okay.
Got some weapons you could sell.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Hey. Maka.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you or me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little. Pearson! Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch. You tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I mean, I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town. Things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a corner tiger. Anyway... Somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Colm O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parlay? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap, you shoot the lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance you've gotta take.
I killed Combs' brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I love dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
Mount up then, Morgan.
Let's go then.
Whoa there.
You know, I've been fighting Combs for so long now. I
can barely remember a time when it was different.
And you're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Well, maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? Yeah, Pinkerton's coming after us.
Because of Blackwater?
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll?
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look, you ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover. For us, hmm?
Okay. Just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I. Hey, up there, men on the ridge.
O'Driscoll's, from the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big. Caring too much. That's my problem.
Caring too much? There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Colm O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all, that might be nonsense too, but it's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
All right, cowpoke. You're gonna peel off up ahead. We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot just above us where you can keep an eye on things.
All right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Yep.
Hello, Dutch. It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing? They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world. Hmm? How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader. A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us. Whole heap of trouble. They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here? Go home. Is this thing over?
Got a sense.
Handing him over to the law, it's, I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella Colum's right, we can draw them all back.
True. Where'd Colum?
He's escaping! Shoot him! Relax! Relax! I got him.
Did I kill you?
Oh, not yet.
No, of course not. Not yet.
But I will.
This guy's superhuman or something. I'm pretty sure he just shot me with a fucking double barrel shotgun and I'm still fucking alive.
Finally! Put his weapons over there!
Morgan. It's good to see you.
Hello, Colm.
How's the wound?
I hardly feel it.
You will. Septic? Ain't nice. Now, tell me. Fine gun like you. But why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Colm.
Oh, no. It's Dutch's famous cars. You killed a whole bunch of my boys. Six-point gag.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached true.
Let me go, Colm, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it. They get him. They forget about me.
They ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. But see, we lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
So you only met with him to grab me?
Of course. He gonna be so mad. He gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Arthur.
Arthur. I missed you.
In a minute. What the hell?
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
Do that again.
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. You better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law... comes for that side of beef.
Morgan's
My dear boy, what? They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help! Reverend Swanson!
He's gonna set the law on us!
Oh, of course he was!
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan,
you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur.
I got you.
You're safe now.
That's pretty, it does. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, River.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too. Coming for me, right, Dutch?
Of course, son. Good to see you back up and at 'em again.
3 years ago, I lost my leg, and I've been hopping ever since. It ain't no fun.
Good morning.
Hey! Hey, it's good to see you again, friend. But, what you doing here?
Just visiting old friends, I guess.
Well, you better get out of here. There's a bunch of government agents I met asking about you all across town. Yeah, them and a bunch of bounty hunters, too, I think.
So?
Yeah. Yeah, but you don't seem too scared.
Guess not.
Well, they seem pretty mad. What'd you do?
Nothing good.
Well, you better get out of here.
Extra, extra. Come and get it.
Hey there, ma'am.
How you doing?
Pockets are feeling pretty heavy.
I'm sure you got better things to do than hang around an old cripple like me.
Long time no see. Take a look. Any questions, feel free not to ask.
Now, let me have a look.
Fine.
That's it for now.
Bye.
Tell me you've seen Gavin.
I don't even know what he looks like.
Big bloke. Cockney. Londoner. Hilarious. Oh, we've had such times, me and Gav.
No, sorry. I've yet to meet any hilarious Londoners.
Oh, he's the best.
Gavin!
Oh, I am so worried.
Gav! 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 Where are you?
Where are you? I am so worried.
Yep. Gav. Gav.
Whoa.
Can I help you?
Well, looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Well, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
How about the stables, I think?
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
Everybody, and there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attacked my fields.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
The hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants! I don't know. Mongrels! Slave fuckers! All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbreds.
Adelante. Orale.
Coming through.
On you go.
Crazy old fool.
If he only knew it was us who torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property. Sean was like a pig in shit.
Talking to Sean, he said to give you a message to meet him, Bill, and Micah in town as soon as you can. Some other job they got going with the Grays.
Another one? Okay. I'll go see what they're up to when we're done with this.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded.
ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
A partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, I... Okay, then, but... Head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Oh. How are you? Yeah. Idiot! That's it. Nice and easy. Need to rush. Don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. All right. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down. Head around the front, hitch up there.
Watch it!
All right, let's hitch up here. That was some riding, girl. Let me do the talking. You're a brave girl. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. That's what you're interested in. What is you boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. Well, this here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle, you get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy. Easy now.
Easy. Marston, you're gonna tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay. Easy. It's okay.
Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions. Easy, you're all right. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems,
We regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two!
What the hell are you doing?
Stop! Stop! We're being robbed! I said stop these men! Stop!
They're coming out of the fields!
What's my horse doing?
Whoa now! Hey, hey!
Just over there. Come on.
Easy.
Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. Yeah. Enough. You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
Whoa, now.
Come here.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you... I can give you 650 for them.
I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys, but I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believed a yarn spun us by one of that Gray family and imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.